Just think about what we can accomplish in the first 100 days of a Trump administration.
For a man used to tracking his TV ratings and then his poll numbers...
Have you been seeing what's happening with those polls? They're like rocket ships.
The measurement of President Trump's first 100 days is a tougher score to reckon with.
He doesn't like for there to be an umpire calling balls and strikes. This is why he doesn't like the press.
Michael D'Antonio, a Trump biographer, should know.
He is aware of what the real score is. And he's aware now that we're getting to the 100-day mark that presidents have been judged by that first 100 days all the way back to FDR.
It's a ritual, a moment to take stock and ask another biographer.
Has the presidency changed Donald Trump?
We're really early in this. I don't think someone who is about to turn 71 years old and has been the same person since he was 4 years old is going to get changed overnight by the presidency.
Do you think the office has humbled him in any way? You're laughing, but...
Yes, yes. I don't think anything will ever humble Donald Trump.
I do think he's understanding now that he needs friends, he needs allies, he needs the world to be on his side as often as possible. So, yes, I think the office is humbling him a bit, and it may have been the only responsibility on earth that would ever visited humility upon Donald Trump.
Oval Office aside,
the so-called architect,
these Donald Trump watchers say he's still Donald Trump, tweeting.
Trump has been planting gossip items his whole life.
Craving attention.
He would be bereft if that spotlight turned away from him.
Look at all of those cameras.
Changing the conversation.
I think that what we have seen in the president's distortions, misstatements, and really occasionally outright lies is him attempting to use the method he always used in the past to get out of a jam. Say anything, divert attention, and run on to the next topic.
He runs his White House like he ran his business, often improvising.
He's the king of chaos. I think he likes being right in the middle of the storm.
The anchors remain his family.
You think Ivanka and Jared are there because he has a comfort level with them?
At the end of the day, he'll always come back to family. It's been true of his business life. That's how the Trump Organization was run. It's a little boutique business that he populated with family members or quasi-family members. And he's trying to replicate that in the White House. And I think Ivanka and Jared are there for a few reasons. They're more willing to be the public faces of the White House than I think he is. I don't think he's that interested in doing that constantly. And then I think he also just doesn't trust people.
I do have the sense that this is a lonely president. This is a man who's always loved to be surrounded by good friends, long-term friends, by family members. I think this is why he travels to Florida so often. I think it's a cure for the loneliness. I don't think he's comfortable with the Washington crowd.
I think we're going to get a winner vote.
Especially if he's getting drowned by it, like he was with the health care defeat, which he vows to revisit soon.
When he first went bankrupt in the early 1990s, it was because he kept doubling down and he kept pushing to get a success when really he was throwing good money after bad. And I think that's what happened with the healthcare struggle.
Thank you very much. We were very close.
He went too far down the road and was left embarrassed.